I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Okay. Roll call.
Mr. McGill?
Here.
Mr. Katara?
Here.
Mrs. Meany?
Here.
Mr. Palunas?
Here.
Mr. Russo?
Here.
Mr. Schmitz?
Here.
Mr. Zellwin?
Here.
Okay, changes to the agenda, we have none. Announcements are as published. Comments from the audience? Are there any comments from the audience? Okay. We'll move on then to Planning Commission Consent. Item number one.
An application was received from Danette Brown for property located at 6690 Solon Boulevard for a lot split of permanent parcel 954-07200 for a 2,479 square foot lot area variance for each lot, and it was approved, and the Planning Commission also approved the lot split.
Thank you. Item number two.
An application was received from Arbor Court Properties LLC for property located at 30775 Bainbridge Road for a 10-foot sign setback variance, which was approved contingent upon a registered surveyor staking the right-of-way.
Thank you. Item number three.
An application was received from Michael Dermott for a property located at 37955 Aurora Road for a secondary driveway divergence variance, which the Planning Commission approved, and a driveway material variance. Planning Commission also approved contingent upon the applicant's purchase of the property.
Thank you. Item number four.
An application was received from Joshua and Nicole Dodovic for property located at 34800 Dogwood Lane for a 13-foot front yard setback variance, which was also approved.
Mr. Palunas.
Move to approve the Planning Commission consent agenda.
Okay, I have a motion. Okay, motion by Mr. Palunas, seconded by Mr. McGill. Roll call, please.
Mr. Katara?
Yes.
Mr. McGill? Mrs. Meany?
Yes.
Mr. Palunas?
Yes.
Mr. Russo?
Yes.
Mr. Schmitz?
Yes.
Mr. Zellwin?
Yes.
Okay, we'll move on to new item number five.
Ordinance number 2019-58, an ordinance accepting the bid of American Fireworks for the 2019 4th of July fireworks display and declaring an emergency.
Mr. Zellwin.
This item was discussed at tonight's Finance Committee meeting. It is for the 4th of July fireworks display, which is going to be on the 3rd of July again this year. And it's in the amount of $26,000, and we're going to do this under suspension and emergency. I make a motion to approve under suspension.
I'll second.
Okay, I have a motion for Mr. Zellwin, seconded for Mr. Russo. Roll call under suspension.
Mr. Katara?
Yes.
Mr. McGill?
Yes.
Mrs. Meany?
Yes.
Mr. Palunas?
Yes.
Mr. Russo?
Yes.
Mr. Schmitz?
Yes.
Mr. Zellwin?
Yes.
Final passage.
Mr. Katara?
Yes.
Mr. McGill?
Yes.
Mrs. Meany?
Yes.
Mr. Palunas?
Yes.
Mr. Russo?
Yes.
Mr. Schmitz?
Yes.
Mr. Zellwin?
Yes.
Okay.
Item number six.
Ordinance number 2019-59, an ordinance amending section 234.12 of the Administration Code Investment Policy.
And we're going to leave this on first reading. Item number seven.
Ordinance number 2019-60, an ordinance approving the Second Amendment to the Joint Economic Development District contract with Bainbridge Township and declaring an emergency.
And we are also going to leave this on first reading. Okay, we're going to move then on to the consent portion of our agenda. Item number eight.
Ordinance number 2019-61, an ordinance accepting the final contract adjustment with the Northeast Ohio Trenching for the Sherwood Drive Storm Sewer Replacement Project.
Mr. Couture.
This legislation approves the final change order to the Sherwood Drive Storm Sewer Replacement Project Contract 2016.28, which reduces the contract by $1,308.15 and closes the contract out in the amount of $100,682.24 to Northeast Ohio Trenching.
Thank you. Item number nine.
Ordinance number 2019-62, an ordinance accepting a final contract adjustment with Roniak Paving for the 2017 Annual Asphalt Repair Program.
Mr. Schmitz.
Yes, this is the approval for the final change order with Roniak Paving Company for the 2017 Annual Asphalt Repair Program, contract number 2017-08. It closes out the contract in the amount of $1,296,178.59.
Thank you. Item number 10.
Ordinance number 2019-63, and ordinance accepting the bid of Trimore Corporation for the 2019 Annual Concrete Repair Program and declaring an emergency.
Mr. Couture.
On February 22, 2019, six sealed bids were received and opened for the 2019 Annual Concrete Repair Program Contract 2019-03. The lowest responsive and responsible bidder was Trimore Corporation. Trimore has experience with this type of work, having performed the same project in 2011, 2012, 2013, 14, 16, and 18. Trimore Corp also is the current contractor for the city's emergency road repair program, and they have performed that program in the past in years 2011, 12, 16, 17, and 18. This legislation does award the 2019 Annual Concrete Repair Program contract to Trimore under emergency so that we can begin construction as soon as possible in the amount of $2,317,905.
Thank you. Item number 11.
Ordinance number 2019-64, and ordinance authorizing the mayor or his designee to enter into an LPA agreement with the Ohio Department of Transportation for the Somme Center Road Resurfacing Project, US 422, to the railroad bridge and declaring an emergency.
Mr. Schimmitz.
Yes, this authorizes the mayor to enter into an agreement with the Ohio Department of Transportation for the Somme Center Resurfacing Project, which will go from the US 422 to the railroad bridge. What this authorizes this LPA agreement, which means local project agency. I'm not going to get into all the details. Maybe Matt, if you don't mind, maybe bringing that up when it's your turn to just to kind of explain a little bit about it. I appreciate that. We have this done under emergency so we can get this construct this project during this construction season.
Thank you. Item number 12.
Ordinance number 2019-65. And ordinance authorizing the mayor or his designee to enter into an agreement with the Ohio Development Services Agency to accept a roadwork development grant for the Bainbridge Road Traffic Signal Project and declaring an emergency.
Mr. Couture.
The engineering department, with the aid of GPD, has developed the plans and specifications for the installation of a new traffic signal and crosswalk on Bainbridge Road at the Nestle 500 building located at 30500 Bainbridge Road. The city of Solon applied for and was successful in obtaining $100,000 from the Ohio Development Services Agency, known as the ODSA. This particular legislation authorizes the mayor to enter into the OSDA Roadwork Development Grant Agreement and accept the grant for $100,000 and to execute all the necessary paperwork, and this is being passed under emergency in order to secure the funding.
Thank you. Item 13.
Ordinance number 2019-66, and ordinance approving a change order extending the completion date of the contract with Herbst Electric Company for the Water Reclamation Facility Preliminary Treatment Improvement Project, Contract B, and declaring an emergency.
Mr. Schimmitz.
Yes, this legislation is to approve the contract B 2016.26 as a no cost time extension of 52 days to April 19, 2019 for the preliminary treatment improvement project at the water rec and declare an emergency.
Thank you. Item 14.
Ordinance number 2019-67. An ordinance accepting the bid of J. Barker Landscaping Company for mulch services and declaring an emergency.
Mr. Couture.
This legislation approves the city mulch, the city property mulch contract number 19006 to J. Barker Landscaping Company for a period of 4 years in the total amount of $62,640.
Thank you. Item 15.
Ordinance number 2019-68, and ordinance authorizing the purchase of ballistic vests for use by the fire department from Atwell's Police and Fire Equipment through the State of Ohio Cooperative Purchasing Program and declaring an emergency.
Mr. McGill.
This legislation authorizes our fire department to purchase 59 ballistic vests for their use through the State of Ohio Cooperative Purchasing Program in the amount of $47,967 under emergency.
Thank you. Item 16.
Ordinance number 2019-69, and ordinance accepting the proposal of Progressive Roofing, A.W. Farrell and Son Incorporated, for the replacement of the roof system of a cold storage facility at the service department through the Ohio School Council Cooperative Purchasing Program and declaring an emergency.
Mr. Russo?
Sure. The current roofing system is the original and in need of a complete replacement of the roof membrane, insulation, and related components, and approximately 50% of the metal decking material. This contract was awarded to Progressive Roofing in the amount of $55,450.
Thank you. Item 17.
Ordinance number 2019-70. An ordinance amending the traffic control map and traffic control file to prohibit parking on a section of Carter Street.
Mr. McGill.
In order to correct an ongoing problem, this adjusts the traffic control map and traffic control file, which are sections 406.04 and 406.05 of the traffic code, to prohibit parking on the north side of Carter Street eastbound for 940 feet.
Thank you. Item 18.
Ordinance number 2019-71. An ordinance accepting the proposal and authorizing the purchase of a jail facility master control and facility monitoring system, including trade-in, for use by the police department from Stanley Convergent Security Solutions through the Sourcewell Cooperative Purchasing Program and declaring an emergency.
Mr. Russo?
Sure. The jail master control panel was installed in the police facility in 1997. During the time of original construction. The original vendor is out of business, and the system is archaic and failing. So this will be a replacement in the amount of $277,030.
Thank you. Item 19.
Ordinance number 2019-72, and ordinance accepting the bids of Village Outdoors, Harold's Turf LLC, Walker Supply, Nutrient Solutions, Helena Chemical, Site One Landscape, and Advanced Turf Solutions for pesticide products for use at Grantwood Recreational Park, declaring an emergency.
Mr. Palunas.
Yes, this was approved at the Finance Committee at 6 p.m. this evening. These are the lowest bidders for the pesticide products for use at the Grantwood Recreational Park.
Thank you. Item 20.
Ordinance number 2019-73, and ordinance accepting the bid of Site One Landscape, Helena Chemical, and Nutrient Solutions for fertilizer projects for use at Grantwood Recreational Park and declaring an emergency.
Mr. Zellwin.
This item was also discussed at the Finance Committee this evening, and it is to approve the fertilizer needs for Grantwood Golf Course to the lowest bidders in the amount of $7,659.25.
Thank you. Item 21.
Ordinance number 2019-74, and ordinance authorizing the Director of Finance to request proposals for event planning consulting services for the 2020 City of Solon Bicentennial Celebration and declaring an emergency.
Mr. Palunas.
Yes, this is for an RFP for the Director of Finance to solicit proposals for our bicentennial celebration.
Thank you. Item 22.
Ordinance number 2019-75, and ordinance authorizing the execution of then and now certificates by the Director of Finance and the payment of amounts due for various purchase orders and declaring an emergency.
Mr. Zellwin.
Yes, this item is to approve 8 then and now certificates that were discussed at tonight's Finance Committee meeting.
Thank you. Item 23.
Ordinance number 2019-76, and ordinance adopting the annual appropriations for personal services and other expenditures of the City of Solon for the period January 1st, 2019 to December 31st, 2019 and declaring an emergency.
Mr. Palunas.
Yes, this amends the Economic Incentive Fund and the Sewer Revenue Fund, and these two items were discussed at our Finance Committee meeting earlier this evening, and the reason we are amending this is that we have given quite a few grants already this year, and there's a couple other grants that are going to be expected in the near future. So we want to have the money to be able to appropriate the money for those GRIP grants.
Thank you. Item 24.
Ordinance number 2019-77, and ordinance accepting the bid of True Green Limited Partnership for fertilizer services for city properties and declaring an emergency.
Mr. Couture.
This legislation awards the city property fertilization contract number 19007 to the lowest and best bidder, True Green Limited Partnership, in the amount of $17,997. This contract does allow and contain an option to renew annually for two consecutive one-year terms in 2020 and 2021. This price includes the fertilization and weed control of all city properties, and weed control only for roadside properties. And this is being passed under emergency so that we can begin fertilizing in April.
Thank you. Item 25.
Ordinance number 2019-78, and ordinance accepting the bid of TC Construction for the 2019 annual catch basin repair program and declaring an emergency.
Mr. Schimmitz.
Once again, this is accepting the bid of TC Construction, the 2019 catch basin repair program, in the amount of $161,500 and declaring an emergency.
Thank you. Item 26.
Ordinance number 2019-79, and ordinance accepting the bid of GeoSci Incorporated for the 2019 annual materials testing program and declaring an emergency.
Mr. Couture.
On March 8th, 2019, one sealed bid was received and opened for the 2019 annual materials testing program contract 2019.10. The lowest and best bidder, GeoSci Incorporated, has experience with this work and has completed this same project for the city in 2009, 2011, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, and 18. This legislation awards that 2019 annual materials testing program to GeoSci in the amount of $78,050. This legislation is being passed under emergency in order to be able to utilize the testing services as soon as possible when the construction season, which has already begun.
Thank you. Item 27.
Ordinance number 2019-80, and ordinance authorizing the mayor or his designee to enter into an agreement with Solon, Ohio Retail LLC, care of TLM Realty, under the Growth and Revitalization Incentive Program and declaring an emergency.
Mr. Russo.
Sure. Okay, so this will improve and demolish an 84,180 square foot facility at 6217 and 6221 Sound Center Drive. This is the location that would be known as Sears. The improvements shall include but are not limited to extensive facade work, tear off roof and replace, new HVAC, new utilities, new flooring, drywall, retail finishes, new bathrooms, extensive landscaping, planted islands, curb work, and mill and repave the entire parking lot, new sidewalks and LED light fixtures. The project is expected to have an investment of $1.5 million. Construction will begin approximately in March of this year, and which should be completed by the end of August. The grant is in the amount of $70,000.
Thank you. Item 28.
Ordinance number 2019-81, and ordinance authorizing the mayor or his designee to enter into an agreement with yours truly of Solon Incorporated under the Growth and Revitalization Incentive Program and declaring an emergency.
Mr. Couture.
This legislation authorizes the mayor to enter into an agreement with yours truly of Solon Incorporated under the Growth and Revitalization Incentive Program for approximately $800,000 in improvements to 6141 Cruzy Drive. This grant is in the amount of $50,000.
Thank you. Okay, that brings us to the end of our consent agenda. Make a motion.
Move to approve the consent agenda.
Under suspension?
Under suspension.
Okay, I have a motion for Mr. Zellwin, seconded for Mr. Schimmitz. Roll call under suspension.
Mr. Katora?
Yes.
Mr. McGill?
Yes.
Mrs. Meany?
Yes.
Mr. Palunas?
Yes.
Mr. Russo?
Yes.
Mr. Schimmitz?
Yes.
Mr. Zellwin?
Yes.
Final passage.
Mr. Katara?
Yes.
Mr. McGill?
Yes.
Mrs. Meany?
Yes.
Mr. Palunas?
Yes.
Mr. Russo?
Yes.
Mr. Shimmets?
Yes.
Mr. Zellwin?
Yes.
Okay, comments from the audience? Are there any comments from the audience? Okay, we'll bring it back up to the dais here for comments from council, starting with Mr. Russo.
Would like to thank Mr. Malik and the religious leaders and the citizens of Solon that showed up yesterday for the vigil that was held for the victims in Christchurch, New Zealand on Friday. It's just unfortunate that we had to have a vigil like this, but I think it was heartwarming to see the show of support that all the citizens of Solon had in support of each other. Also would like to recognize Jay Catatano. He did finish second in the state wrestling tournament, and he will be continuing his wrestling career at Ohio State University.
Great. Thank you. Mr. Zellwin.
Yes, yes.
I'm going to really mix them up tonight. Keep you guys all off.
I want to echo Bill's remarks and thank Ms. Warren and Cindy Malik for the helping organize the vigil yesterday and the members of the Michigan Valley Islamic Center. It for me tonight, Nancy.
Okay. Mr. Shimmets?
Nothing tonight, thank you.
Okay. Mr. Palunas?
Nothing tonight.
Mr. Katara?
No comments this evening.
Mr. McGill?
Good grief, everybody's giving me all their time.
Doesn't mean you get more time.
I would like to also thank everybody that showed up yesterday, particularly all of the religious leaders of a number of different faiths that took the time out of their day to come to Solon. Some of them traveled all the way from the west side to speak and to recognize and remember those that sacrificed their lives in Christ Church. I would like to recognize Samuel Ogun Toyimbo. He's a senior at Solon High School. He won a $40,000 scholarship by writing an essay from the Maltz Museum. It's pretty significant. Congratulations to Samuel. I'd also like to recognize, again, we did this last year, Dan Sesse, his team. The Solon Speech and Debate Team at Solon High School is sending 9 people to the national tournament in Dallas in June. It seems to me that every year he's sending somebody to the national tournament. That is terrific. And they just won the O'Leary Excellence in Speech Award, which is a national award for the school. So congratulations to Dan Sesse and his team. And on this date in 1866, the British Parliament repealed the Stamp Act because of violent protests in the colonies. And also, this is the birthday of Grover Cleveland, the only president to ever serve non-contiguous terms. Thank you.
Just love the history lessons. I love history, so thank you, Mr. McGill.
1766, right?
1766. Hey, okay, I too want to echo the comments made about the event, yesterday at the gazebo. It was sad that this continues to happen, that we continue to have events like this, but I think for all of us there, it made a horrific situation, you know, maybe a little bit less painful just coming together as a community. I was really proud of everyone from Solon and those even not from Solon, all the faith based community, you know, leaders that came and spoke. Like I say, it was, I'm getting really sick of it, but this was something, you know, to show the support for the Islamic community. I thought was really, really a good thing for the city to do and shows what kind of city we are. And I'm going to leave it at that. Those are my comments. Doesn't mean you can talk longer. Okay, and now we'll move
talking to me?
Who do you think I'm talking to? Okay, now we're going to move to comments from the administration, starting with the mayor.
Just thank you. So a couple good meetings I had. Just want to let you guys be apprised of one is Monica Blaisdell. She's the regional representative for Lieutenant Governor John Husted. Came to visit, really a great meeting, and I love their focus on business development. Innovation, technology, everything they're doing with the new administration down in Columbus, and he seems very active and willing to really be a partner with municipalities as we continue to grow our business community. I want to thank Sharon Reitblatt, a former Solon resident who runs the DBSA, which is the Depression and Bipolar Support Alliance. It's really nice to have them in the community to provide those services. They have counseling, they have support sessions for those that need it, and it's a really nice opportunity for people to come together and to talk about these issues that for probably many years were swept under the rug, but now people are actually discussing it, and there's help out there for people that have these difficult situations in their life. I want to thank Dries Holmes. They met with Angie and I. It was a really great meeting and talking about some possibilities and some opportunities in Solon. I want to thank yours truly and Wendy's for really putting forth some great work sessions that we had as a team, and they really helped us a lot in understanding their vision for their particular restaurants and really worked with us in a very meaningful way to make two new beautiful restaurants in our community. I want to thank Paytime for having me visit, a great company out on Bainbridge Road. Been here a long time, and they're doing some great work. I had a chance to attend the Destination Cleveland annual meeting, and former resident Dave Gilbert's doing some great things. And we in Solon benefit from all the great things they're doing with Destination Cleveland, bringing more tourists and more people to the region, which inevitably helps our community as well. I want to congratulate Glenn Gable with the opening of the Escape Room, Escapeology. Great place. Glenn will do great things, as he always does, being the entertainment master for the city of Solon. And lastly, it was great, the vigil yesterday. The one thing, my takeaway was all the people from the Chagrin Valley Islamic Center, and I suspect you guys felt it as well, how much they appreciate our support. It's just, it's amazing, just something that you can do, just a hug or, you know, just an expression of your condolence and support, and how much they appreciate it. They really feel like they have support and friends and colleagues with all of us, and I could see how much they mean it, and they know that from us up here that it's very heartfelt and that we really mean it. So it was made a very difficult weekend coming out of it with some support and hope and friendship and love. So thank you.
And I'm going to just interject real quick, because there's a group of people that I did forget to thank, and that's our police chief over there, who was at the event yesterday. It really meant a lot, I know, for all of us. Chief, for you to be there, for your officers, like I say, thank you. So I'm sorry to kind of butt in again, but I wanted to just, so thank you. Mr. Lobey?
No comments.
Mrs. McConney?
No comments.
Chief Island?
Nothing tonight, thank you.
Chief Shaw?
Just a reminder that this Wednesday, March 20th at 9:50 a.m., we are going to participate in the statewide tornado drill by sounding the outdoor warning sirens. I ask the public, please do not call 911 and ask what is going on. That floods the phone lines and prevents them from dealing with true emergencies.
Thank you. Mr. Rubino?
Councilman Schimitz had asked about some additional information on LPA agreements. I'll defer to John Bush for that explanation.
Oh, sorry, Matt.
That's okay.
Mr. Franklin?
Nothing tonight, thank you.
Mr. Bandiera?
No comments, thank you.
Mrs. Shaker?
Nothing tonight, thank you.
Mr. Dursick?
Nothing tonight, thank you.
Mr. Bush?
In response to Councilman Schimitz's question, LPA stands for Local Public Agency, and it's administered through the Ohio Department of Transportation, ODOT. ODOT is the federal clearinghouse in Ohio for the federal funds, and it establishes a partnership for LPAs such as Solon and ODOT to spend federal, state, and local funds on projects like 91.
Thank you. Okay, I'll entertain a motion to
motion to adjourn.
Second.
Motion by Mr. Schimitz, seconded by Mr. Zellwin. Roll call, please.
Mr. Katora?
Yes.
Mr. McGill?
Yes.
Mrs. Meany?
Yes.
Mr. Palunas?
Yes.
Mr. Schimitz?
Yes.
Okay. Mr. Almost. Russo?
Yes.
Almost. Mr. Zellwin?
Yes.
Come on, I haven't done it for a while.